Hey everybody, welcome back to the Euro Retro Gamer channel. We are going to take a look at the Kaiko OSSC upscaler. OSSC stands for Open Source Scan Converter and allows you to upscale analog video to HDMI. It uses the line doubling technique to upscale to a maximum of 5 times the original resolution. Upscaler does is it's a line doubler, which means it takes a frame, picks a line, doubles the line in horizontal and vertical resolution, and outputs a bigger image that way. It features options to double 2 to 5 times, depending on the incoming resolution of the device you're connecting to it. This OSSC device is created by Kaiko, which is a British company, and they are specialized in various accessories and devices like this to upscale video or to create a better video image. The OSSC software and device are engineered by Video Game Perfection, and they made this device open source, which means that everybody can make their own version if they want to. And this company Kaiko did, and this is the result. In order to make this device work, you need RGB output on your console, and you can use RGB SCART cables, component cables, or a VGA cable in the case of a Dreamcast. Be aware that the SCART cable outputs an RGB signal. There are many SCART cables that output a composite signal. The absolute biggest feature of OSSC is that there's zero to no lag, while most other upscalers do have lag, even FrameMeister. And there's a high compatibility out of the box. Most systems run perfectly fine with the default settings. Unfortunately, it isn't perfect. Most 8-bit systems do not output RGB or use an RF cable, and you have to mod your console. Unfortunately, the OSSC also have a lot of problems with the Super Nintendo. It just won't output a stable output resolution and frequency. It is considered the Achilles heel of the OSSC. There's a big thread on Junker HQ with settings you can try to get a Super Nintendo to work, but the tuning can be pretty overwhelming and technical. Time for the unboxing. Let's get this package open and get everything out. And compared to low quality Chinese ripoffs, this Kaiko edition of the OSSC is really well packaged and complete. We're looking at the contents of the box, and this is just a regular AC adapter. They have various plugs for your local needs. By the way, at the time of making this video, this device was 196 euros, comparable to the Video Game Perfection version, which is 157, including VAT. But the Kaiko version is coming including a remote control. If you buy the original OSSC developed by Video Game Perfection, you have to buy this as an accessory. And the same goes for the AC adapter, by the way. But if you add everything up, then the Kaiko version is a little bit cheaper than the Video Game Perfection edition. And the remote control and AC adapter are identical to the Video Game Perfection ones. As you can see, the device is a little bit bare bones. It has a PCB and some shielding plates around it. You can see two buttons here, which you can use to navigate the menu, and some sockets to add some firmware upgrades. And last but not least, an LCD display. On this side, you find the HDMI out and some audio in and output. And this side features the SCART and component inputs. And last but not least is the power switch, the VGA input and the AC socket. Remote control is a little bit confusing at first glance, but it does make sense once you learn to work with the features that the device has, and is much more convenient than using the buttons on the device itself. And here a little insight into the multilingual manual. It does feature the basics, but I learned to find that I did need the internet quite a bit to get a grip on all the features. Let's try the device out of the box with some systems and see what the results are. Let's start with Mega Drive, or the Genesis if you're from the United States or Canada. And as you can see, out of the box I can line double this 3 times and to a resolution of 720p, and it looks very, very nice. Not a lot of distortion, and out of the box it just works. There's a little bit of distortion on the audio, but that has more to do with get accustomed with new capture software. Because the biggest problem with this device is that it's not very compatible with the Elgato HD60 and creates very awkward resolutions. Depending on which region and which system, it does not always output standard resolutions. So if you're into capturing video for streaming or for YouTube videos and stuff like that, you either have to invest in another 4K device, for example, which does accept these resolutions, like the Elgato Cam Link, or go for a FrameMeister, which actually upscales to a default 180p resolution, if I'm correct. But for playing games on a big TV, this definitely does the job. Let's take a look at Dreamcast games. The main reason to buy a device like this was for my Dreamcast games. With the Dreamcast I used a 480p VGA cable, 2 times doubled, so there's a line to X mode, and it looks really nice. It does have a little bit of a distortion, but in general it looks really good. One thing I can say is that it looks a little bit better with 3D games, because you have a little bit more softening of the edges, which make it just really pleasant to look at. And Crazy Taxi here looks incredibly sharp. You do have to keep in mind that textures are not upscaled. They are upscaled, but if the textures are low resolutions, and most of the time on these 32-bit systems, the Achilles heel is that the textures are a little bit more low res than modern systems. They do pop out, because everything else, all the 3D models are very sharp, and the textures look a little bit fuzzy, like the palm trees here. You can see the difference in the grass. I also want to take a look at Formula One World Grand Prix. Well, in motion this looks really good as well. The slowdown is not created by the OSSC, but it's just a game that has a really big frame drops in corners, especially and when there's a lot of objects along the road. But as I'm a racing fan,
and race game fan, this has my particular interest how this looks, but it looks really good. It's also interesting to take a look at Japanese import games that I have. When you're outputting on a PAL system and you're outputting an NTSC game, and it could end up with some troubles, especially on the PlayStation systems. The Dreamcast seemed to be handling quite well. I run the Saturn over SCART, as I did with Mega Drive and with the PlayStation in these examples. And the only thing I use the VGA output for is the Dreamcast. And the Dreamcast runs 480p, so that's two times doubled to 960. But this is just 240p doubled three times to 720p. And look at this, this looks really nice. So let's try some 2D action on Sega Saturn. The Saturn is very popular for its 2D games, and the problem is with 2D games and upscaling that it ends up upscaling sprites that could become a little bit jaggy, as you can see here. Pretty apparent on Sega Saturn, but there are some options in the option menu to feather that a little bit out. So, but that is a little bit of advanced knowledge of the OSSC. Let's take a look at the PlayStation. The biggest problem with the PlayStation is, and PlayStation 2 as well, is that there's a lot of switching between resolutions. And if there's something capture cards can handle, that is switching between resolutions. All my capture applications like OBS and the Elgato capture software crash on switching between resolutions when they come out of the OSSC. Don't bother if you want to stream PlayStation games with an OSSC and OBS, for example. And some games for PlayStation just act up when you use OSSC. Yeah, Gekido, for example, this is the PAL version playing in 240p resolution, but there's a lot of jittering, and you can see it on the intro screen, some sort of frame flashing in between, and you see a green flash. It's very apparent when you use a capture card. It's a little bit less obvious when you just use it to display on the big TV. PlayStation always seemed to be a problem. PlayStation 2 as well, because PlayStation 2 uses an output of 480i. Well, the OSSC interprets it as 525i, and interlaced video does not go well with OSSC. But you can use a hardware deinterlacer to deinterlace the interlaced video, which makes it a little bit better, but still it moves a lot and is actually very dangerous for your TV if you leave it in idle mode, because the jittering can destroy your panel. And the last game we're going to take a look at is Castlevania Symphony of the Night. And I must say, this looks really, really nice. It's as sharp as it can be. My general conclusion is that it does depend on which game you play in regards to the PlayStation. In general, all the Saturn games out of the box go pretty good. I don't see any problems there. And the Dreamcast games, well, some games don't support 480p in VGA mode, so. But you have always the option to use the SCART connector to upscale the video. On the TV you do see a little bit of jittering, and it doesn't really show on the capturing device, but it is there. But also that can all be fine-tuned within the menus. So if you upscale your video, say 3 times, then the timing gets a little bit off and you need to manually adjust it. In conclusion, I really, really like this device. It's a little bit tough to get into. You do need a little bit of attention and a little bit of internet searching to get the maximum out of it. But out of the box, it does really function well, especially with the Sega Saturn and Dreamcast and the Mega Drive. PlayStation, Sony devices in general do give a little bit more of a hassle with the switching between different resolutions within a game, that the title screen is in a higher resolution than the game itself. In a later stage, I will make some console specific how-tos on how to set up the device for specific consoles, but I have to learn a little bit extra. In regards to production quality of the Kaiko version of the LSSC, I must say it looks exactly the same as the Video Game Perfection version. There is a lot of talk about the differently produced versions from the Video Game Perfection OSSC, that they are sloppy produced with lower quality materials and lower quality components, but this is spot on. This is more or less exactly the same. And it has a really nice manual as well, which explains a lot of the functions that are in the manual. But I also recommend to look at the JunkerHQ.net forums for more information about open source scan converter, but also other upscalers. And the forums of Video Game Perfection, because there's a lot of information there as well. Well, thanks for watching, and hope to see you next time on another video. If you like, please like and subscribe, and bye-bye.